Hi everybody, just giving you a quick update and shout outs. It's been such a long time since I've been regular with my videos, and hopefully now I can get back to that. As you know, I've been seeing my rheumatologist every 2 months, and you know, and all my other doctors, and you know, I have the bariatric surgery coming up hopefully in February. And just a whole lot going on. I actually had been on the Plaquenil now, I think just over 3 months. I've been doing fairly well. I do have some color change on my skin. I'm going to put some pictures up, but I'm also going to see if you can see. And you can't really tell here. Let's see. But I'll put some pictures up. All my color is gone. And you'll be able to see my hands and look at the upper forearms, this part of my arm, when I put the photos up at the end. And you can kind of see what's going on. I don't know why I'm changing colors, why I'm, you know, I jokingly tell people in my lupus support group that I'm turning white. And I'm not sure if that's because of the Plaquenil or if it was because of a flare of some sort. But as you all know, I have been having problems getting an official diagnosis from my rheumatologist, and he sent me home, I think I saw him in December. He sent me home in December with some information, and voila, among the information for me to read about systemic lupus, yeah, okay, and some other stuff on here. He said he's really not sure, because he said my test results are always all over the place, and he gets a little frustrated when dealing with me, so he says I'm a hard case. But he gave me this to read about systemic lupus, and this is actually, these pages are instructions and diagnoses. So among the diagnoses is systemic lupus erythematosus, and then telling me what to do at home to care for myself with SLE, what to do, when to get prompt medical attention. And on the back, there are some additional diagnoses, and I'll put these all up too, but it has official diagnosis, and I'm going to kind of read them. But among them, in addition to the SLE, is connective tissue disease, undifferentiated, the lumbosacral spondylosis without myelopathy. I haven't looked all of these up, so it might be your first time hearing it, but I rest assured it's my first time hearing some of these too. I have the osteoarthritis, unspecified whether generalized or localized in the lower leg, hypermobility syndrome, enthesopathy of hip region. What is this? PES, PES planus, photosensitivity, obesity, encounter for long-term use of other medications. I don't know what that means. Dysuria, chronic fatigue syndrome, and unspecified vitamin D deficiency. That's a long list. You know, I went from not get having any diagnosis to about 15 diagnoses. But at any rate, I'm just glad that it seems like we are moving forward. I go back and see him in February, so I guess I'll have some more information. I had been doing so much better that I've actually went out and done a few mystery shops, which I hadn't done probably since 2009. I'm still not able to go out and get a job full time because I still have too much day-to-day pain and limitations. So I actually have not been able to do that yet. Social Security is still on appeal level, but I have been sending, information in as I can. Every time I get something from my doctors, I send it to them. Let's see, bariatric surgery coming up. My knee, I did something to my knee. I went into a flare in early January and or late December, and my right knee really started giving me a lot of problems. And long story short, fast forward to 2 weeks ago, my orthopedic surgeon had me go and do some get some MRIs. Got those back, went in and met with him today, and without warning, he decided to drain some of the fluid off of my knee, which I was not happy about. And then, of course, he injected some what's the stuff? Ooh, what is it? Cortisone in there as well. And he said I needed to have surgery, which I am preparing for. But this is what they said about the MRI that I had done. Findings. Let's see. The anterior and posterior cruciate ligaments are intact. The lateral meniscus is intact. The medial meniscus shows meniscal root tear involving the posterior horn near the meniscotibial insertion, where there appears to be transaction or transection of the meniscus from free edge to periphery. There is degenerative intrasubstance signal within the posterior horn and body of the medial meniscus. There is questionable additional horizontal tears in the posterior horn medial to the root tear. The osseosis structures are intact, no fractures seen. There are degenerative medial and lateral, or excuse me, medial and lateral compartment spurs larger medially. There is marked cartilage loss over the weight-bearing surfaces of the medial femoral condyle and the medial tibial plateau. There is a large joint infusion. So, long story short, so I don't have to read all this. I really needed to read it with read it first so I can sound out the words before I actually read it. But long story short, he gave me an injection today and he drained the fluid off from around my right knee. And yes, I have to have surgery. In addition to my sister being in the hospital in a different state with a aneurysm, which I was trying to go see her, looks like I'll be having surgery. And you probably think, well, why wouldn't you just go ahead and go have the surgery and do your knee when you get back, because I really can't walk and just walking on it, especially traveling by air to a different state, is only going to make it worse. So I'll have to see what comes of it over the next few days and see how soon they want to try to do surgery. But that's what's been going on with me. What's been going on with you? And I know that you guys have missed me. I've gotten a few emails, but it looks like people are kind of dropping off and not communicating as much, which I don't think is cool because something could have been wrong and you need to stay in touch. But I am well. I've been doing some mystery shops and, some secret shopping and things like that just to get out every once in a while. I've done some really interesting ones and I have loved them. I've also done a lot by phone so I don't have to leave the home. And those were really good, give me a chance to make a little money on the side. And then in addition to, I get a chance to feel like I'm, being productive again. So just wanted to give you guys a quick shout out. I've already gone a little bit over what I wanted to go. And I'm going to try to do another one this week. Hey, how about that? So let me know what you guys have been doing. If you know anything about all this stuff I read off and you have some tips or some information. And I think I accidentally stopped recording, but I didn't mean to, so that's going to, I'll just have to latch it on to the back of the other one. However, if you guys have any information about any of the diagnoses or any of the conditions that I've read off, please feel free to let me know if you have any tips how I can manage better or any information about anything that I've read off today, just feel free to let me know. It was so good getting back in touch with everyone. Excuse me, and I am going to try to do another video this week. I should be here all week. I don't think I have any more appointments this week. And so I'll see you guys later. And please do be sure to respond. Be sure to let me know how you guys are doing. I will be going back looking at some videos and catching up and stuff. I feel so disconnected, but and I don't like that feeling. So, please give me a shout out and let me know how you're doing and let me know that you watch my video. I'll talk to you soon. Butterfly kisses and pools of spoons. Bye bye.